Do you think they do garlic up here?
Well, we'll see what happens. Don't tell.
No.
Dainty little creatures, with those tough old lumberjacks. They're not as sort of big and brawny as I expected them to be. I thought they'd be sort of...
Well, I think it's the... They all use chainsaws now.
They don't need the muscle.
No, don't need the brawn.
They just go bzzz everywhere. This is very like the Scottish cockaliki.
But without the barley.
Yeah, but I don't like barley. Nasty. It's sort of slippery.
Because you don't like slippery, do you?
Yeah, that'll make a fine great dish.
I thought we might go and try a hand at a little fishing.
Pray do.
Well, I thought you'd like to come too, as chaperone.
It's very wet.
Well, you can sit under an umbrella or something. Come on, be a sport.
Lovely, lovely. What next? You are brave.
Yes, well, one has to be in these matters.
Well, if you didn't have it, you could use Perno.
I suppose one could. Is one more likely to have Perno about one, I wonder?
Yes, quite often. I've always got a bottle of that in the cupboard. I haven't always got a bunch of fennel.
And I caught this fish, and I'm so excited. It's a little like today, and even more humiliating. It was that big.
A minnow?
And they made me throw it back.
Ah.
But actually, a beurre is terribly easy to make.
But it's wonderful of sauces. It's another miracle of the kitchen.
It is wonderful. What is the difference, really, between a ratafia biscuit and a macaroon?
You say ratafia, and I say ratafia.
Well, indeed. Whichever's right now, I don't know.
I once had great trouble with the little ratafias, because I did a receipt for a lemon posset, and that's another miracle thing, you know, where it thickens by the lemon juice, and you're meant to put the little ratafia biscuits in, and they're all meant to amalgamate. I would have thought perfectly safe for anybody. And I got an infuriated letter from a reader saying that not only had he wasted £2 of raspberries, but the vicar's bridge work had been broken. Terrible tale.
Dreadful. Good Lord, what is it, vicar? Is it the bridge work that's holding you back, or your collar?
That's marvellous, isn't it?
We have to get them to sing.
I am a lumberjack, I don't care. That's the Poggy Foggy do, isn't it?
No, they're high heels, panties and a bra. I wish I were a girlie, just like my dear papa. Yes, I think we may get chased off the island.
I think they're probably too young to know the song.
Yes, like policemen.
Yeah, we're so old.
Well, speak for yourself.
Well, I am. Now it's fun time. I've got this lovely little instrument.
What is that?
It's my blowtorch. There's no grill here.
No.
I don't know how to use them, but we'll try. Now, no. I wonder if you would... I'm going to hold it. Would you light it?
Yes, Jennifer.
I'm slightly frightened of it.
You're slightly frightened of it. I'm at the sharp end. Just call me Rome, dear Nero. Yes, quite.
Hey, I'm Matilda.
Yes. Point it at the thing.
Then we'll do a lovely, lovely, bubbly brew. I prefer a good old grill, frankly. Here we are. Quite a little weapon.
Yes, I think I'd stick to the bike if I was you.
No, I just need a little practice.
To say to you?
No, I've never heard it before. My name is more likely to say...
Didn't you have an English nanny?
Yes, I didn't care for her at all after our lovely Chinese armour, this nasty, starched monster, and to us with this terrible smell, probably Dettol or something like that. You know, we weren't used to disinfectants. No. Very dramatic. Like Frankenstein's monster found in a block of ice, or the Snow Queen frozen in her palace.
Yes, dear. Last log of the season, Jennifer.
You are a lumberjack, and you're
alive, okay. Come on, Tug. There's good boy.
She works all night, then she sleeps all day. Sooner her than me. Damn midges. Let's get out of here.
Well, Jennifer, I think this is one cooking experience that you'll be glad to see the back of.
I will. Wet, wet, wet.
Midges, midges, midges.
But nice people.
Sweet people.
With nice habits and got no money at all. And they all said it was lovely last week.
Well, yes. I mean, it's always beautiful the week you haven't been there, isn't it? But the advantage of the wind is it keeps the midges away.
Do you like midges?
No, I'm not fond of them myself.
Freezing cold winds.
Well...
And people come here to stay, you know.
Yes. Anyway, I had a lot of fun. I don't think you enjoyed the adventures as much as I did, but I had a lot of fun.
You got jolly cold in the middle of the river.
I know, but it did have its incentives.
It had the fish.
And the fishermen, yes, quite. And
I must say, the fish here is wonderful. I'll give it that.
Yes. Anyway, well done.
Well done. Very good health. And to Bonnie Scotland. Aye. Something chewy in the mustard. And funnily enough, the French call the aristos being of the gratin, which means upper crust.
Oh, ha.
Then a dainty sprinkling of parsley. Now, there they are, they're all ready.
I need a pound of flour, but there doesn't appear to be any in this rather lavish kitchen.
Oh, it's typical, isn't it?
And don't suggest a supermarket.
No, there's a wonderful mill. I know you won't go into an ordinary little shop, will you?
Good God, no. A little shop, but it's those big things.
To the mill, the mill!
We could probably do it ourselves, Jennifer.
We'll probably get arrested.
Well, for the first time. I wonder where it turns on.
Now, here's a wheel, something like a ship's wheel.
Yeah, that'll be it. Now, I'll watch the main wheel and you turn that, Jennifer.
Quite stiff.
Yeah, well, it will be, but just put some weight into it.
I will. And who better able? Ah, things are happening here. another of your little weird folk tales.
Indeed. Right, I think that's enough.
More than enough, I would say. Look at it. Can we manage?
Yeah, yeah.
Gosh.
Several loaves.
Several loaves of healthy brown bread. Yeah.
I suppose you like white plastic bread.
No, I hate it. I like crusty white.
There we are. You see, look, there's quite a lot of bran left in the bottom.
I just can't eat bran. I find you just chew and can't actually make the final swallow.
Yes.
Now we have to sew it up. Bit of convent training comes in useful here.
Convent training?
Yes, they taught you how to sew. Nobody knows how to sew nowadays.
Yes, well, surgeons sew.
But they sew in a completely different way, don't they? You should know with your father.
Yes, he used to spend all his time sort of practising knots with his left hand. And I remember my mother said that when they were courting, it used to drive her mad because she'd find he'd been doing it to her hair without thinking.
A fine way to start a marriage.
Yes, couldn't get any better.
No, I'm sure we don't.
And couldn't you ask that nice butler you were just chatting up if he'd turn it off all the time?
Perhaps I'd ask him to take it out.
Yes.
Right.
Useful to have a butler.
In my opinion, butlers ought to know their place and not to play the old retainer night and day.
Come on, let's go racing.
These are quite different. These are sweet butlers, aren't they?
He's been a brilliant day. It's just pity. But I hasn't won more money, really, but I'm sorry about that, Jennifer. No treats.
Oh, don't worry. Don't worry. No, don't worry. I've got lots.
Lots? Where from?
Well, I met this gentleman. He was covered in things, you know, for racing. And I said I didn't know much about it. So I chose the names and the colours I like, mostly to do with the Duke. I said, Lord of the Land, which is this land. And then another one called Duke's Delight. And then I plumped for a Raja. And look what I've got. Lots.
How much? Lots.
Treats all round. Off to Capri.
What a lovely thought. Well done. Well, much respect, as they say.
Your health.
Wealth.
And the pursuit of love. Leave the love out of it. Stick to the money.